Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will use a deck of playing cards to simulate the null distribution for the gender discrimination experiment. To recap, the procedure for conducting a hypothesis test is as follows. We start with a null hypothesis, sometimes symbolized as H sub 0, that represents the status quo. We also have an alternative hypothesis, sometimes symbolized as H sub A, that represents our research question, in other words, the effect that we're testing for. Once we collect our data, we then conduct the hypothesis test under the assumption that the null hypothesis is true. This step is quantitative and can be completed either using a numerical simulation or theoretical methods. If the test results suggest that the data do not provide convincing evidence for the alternative hypothesis, we stick with the null hypothesis. If the test results do provide convincing evidence, then we reject the null hypothesis in favor of the alternative. This may all still feel a bit abstract, and that's okay. It can take some time to become comfortable with the details of conducting a hypothesis test. Let's return to the gender discrimination study we were initially discussing and work through the steps of how you would conduct a hypothesis test as a concrete example. We will use a random simulation to generate the null distribution, which represent the range of experimental outcomes we could expect under the assumption that there is no gender discrimination. We then take our randomly generated null distribution and compare it against the collected data. If the results from the simulations based on the chance model look like the data, then we conclude that the difference between the proportions of promoted files between men and women was simply due to chance. On the other hand, if the results from the simulations based on the chance model do not look like the data, then we conclude that the difference between the proportions of promoted files between men and women was not due to chance, and instead due to an actual effect of gender. Let's pretend for a moment that we don't have a computer available to do these simulations. How would I go about generating the null distribution? Well, if you have a standard deck of playing cards available, then you can perform the simulations manually. Here's how. We take out our deck, remove any jokers, and separate our cards into two groups. The groups are the face cards and the number cards. Note that, for the purposes of this demonstration, aces will be counted as face cards. We then remove three aces from the face card group and one number card from the number group. This leaves us with 48 cards in the deck, matching the 48 bank supervisors asked to review personnel files. The 13 face cards match the 13 not promoted outcomes, and the 35 number cards match the 35 promoted outcomes. We now shuffle the cards and deal them into two piles of size 24, with one pile representing men and one pile representing women. What we're effectively doing is handing out 35 promotions at random with no regard to the person's sex. Once we're done dealing into two groups of 24, we count and record how many number cards representing promotions are found in each group. We then calculate the proportion of promoted files in each group, take the difference, and record this value, which is the simulated outcome for this experiment using a random chance model. For the first trial, we obtained a difference in proportions of 1 over 24, which is 4.2%. This simulated outcome by itself is not enough for a hypothesis test, as we need a distribution of outcomes. So, we go and repeat this procedure again and again, shuffling, splitting into two piles, and recording the outcomes for each simulation trial. Next, we take the results of these simulations and plot them as a histogram, giving us our null distribution. We also show the experimental value as a vertical line on the same plot, which gives us a relative comparison between the null distribution and the observed experimental result. The shaded red region corresponds to outcomes that are more extreme than what we observed in experiment. As you can see, the experimental result sits far to the right of the null distribution, with none of the simulated trials resulting in a difference in proportions larger than the observed experimental value. Qualitatively, this means that it is unlikely that this experimental result would arise from chance alone.